The most common objection I get when telling people to start their own YouTube channel is, mate, I can't lie, I'm not really trying to get on camera like that. And trust me, I get it. Running a personal brand channel can be hard work. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make money on YouTube without ever showing your face.
That's the stupidest thing you've done in your whole entire life, you donut.
Roll the intro.
Empty gyms really do give me motor. Just finished my session, notified with this.
Jeez! Before we get into the meat of this video, I just want to quickly explain the difference between a personal brand channel and a cash cow channel. So for me, the pros of starting a personal brand channel are obviously unlimited because you're also growing your personal brand alongside the YouTube channel. So you can be attracting customers for your business, your consulting, your one-on-one coaching, like anything like that. You're also going to be generating leads for yourself as well. But obviously you've got to get on camera every single time. And in terms of scalability, there's only so many hours in a day that you can press record on a camera, edit, upload, etc., etc. Whereas the cash cow channels is something that you can completely automate and delegate and get yourself out of it when it's obviously making money, of course. Now, a cash cow channel is extremely scalable. Once you've built the systems and the processes, you can completely outsource every single component of what it takes to make a new video. And to be honest, one of the only cons of building a cash cow channel is that you're not building your personal brand. However, you are going to be building a brand. So it really just depends on whether you see yourself being the face of this YouTube channel or not. So if you don't want to be in front of a camera, then the cash cow channel is 110% the way you want to go. So what even is a cash cow channel? Google defines it as channels that make money through Google AdSense. Therefore, they try and get as many views as possible. I'm pretty sure that's all of the channels on YouTube anyway, but I understand to a certain extent what they mean. In my opinion, a cash cow channel is a channel that can grow exponentially without any of the owner's input, okay? So if I made a channel, done everything what we're about to go through, and then completely outsourced it, built a team in terms of running that YouTube channel, a successful one is one that is gonna continue to grow and make money and be profitable without me really needing to do any work with it. So how exactly can you get started? The first thing I would do is go and do some research. There are literally thousands and thousands of cash cow channels on YouTube. All you need to do is a little bit of research, and I can almost guarantee that you'll stumble across some of them. Here are a few examples up on the screen right now. These are going to be varying from pet videos to tech videos to news videos, celebrity videos. There are thousands and thousands of niches. I'm also going to leave a couple of ideas in the description below, so make sure you go and check them out as well. Now, once you've done a bit of research, you're going to have a good understanding on what works and what doesn't. Look at the views, look at the thumbnails, look at the titles, see what's working and see what doesn't. And the first step would be picking a niche. The cash cow channels that do really well are very, very, very niche focused. I would definitely recommend picking something that you are passionate about. To a certain extent, right? Because you don't just want to go down the passion, because if the revenue isn't there, then obviously it's not gonna be profitable, right? So I'm not gonna go into so much detail of what the highest paying industries and niches are on YouTube. This is all done with a simple Google search as well. You'll literally be able to see what type of videos get paid more. But just as an example, one of my videos with the least amount of views has made me the most money because of a certain topic I'm talking about in that video. So I hope that helps change the perspective a little bit. While we're on the topic of money, I've been using Free Trade for all of my investing needs, and if you sign up using the link below, me and you both get a free share. I've used a lot of these different investing apps, and Free Trade is hands down the easiest and most beginner-friendly app on the market today. So click the first link in the description and get a free share. In short, pick something that you get excited to create content around, or you know that you will be able to consistently generate content ideas for this subject. So number two would be go back and do some research. Now you've got your niche down, pinpointed, go and research that niche. See if you can find as many videos and as many channels in this niche and this industry as you can, and go ahead and put together 20 to 30 video ideas. I've got a video here where I talk about my entire YouTube video creation sort of process, so go and check that out. It's not necessarily around my Cash Cow channel, however, like, it's the exact same process I follow and my team follow for our Cash Cow channel as well. The next step is obviously getting some videos created. So what I would suggest is creating at least 5 videos before you even contemplate putting them onto YouTube. So obviously, if you want to do this without putting any capital in, then it's going to require your time. But I would honestly recommend doing these first 5 videos yourself, just so if you've never created a YouTube video before, you start to understand the processes and the systems that go into making these videos. Because like I said, when you start to build a team to help you create these videos, you want to know what they're going to be doing. Otherwise, how the hell are you going to manage it? The system for creating these type of videos usually look a little bit like this. Step one, video title and thumbnail. Step two, video script. Step three, voiceover. Step four, finding B-roll copyright free videos. Step five, editing the video together. Step six, finalizing the video. Step seven, uploading the video to YouTube. Simple, right? If you want to create this channel with no upfront capital, then you will need to do all of these steps yourself. However, if you're looking to fund this project, start looking at ways that you can outsource all of the steps we just went through. So if you want to find some freelancers, you want to go to websites like Upwork and Fiverr, and you will need to hire a script writer, a narrator, a video editor, a thumbnail designer, and a virtual assistant to help you out with managing all of the above. Okay, now you're probably thinking, yeah, Ollie, but where is the money? Where the money at? And the main way that these channels do make money is, of course, through Google AdSense. And there is obviously some requirements from YouTube for you to be able to start getting paid from them. And that is 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time. So obviously, just consider that when you're getting started. And if you are putting money into it, please know that it may take a while for you to get any sort of kickback from that. My advice would be to make sure that you aren't just relying on Google AdSense with this Cash Cow channel. Look at affiliate marketing, ways that you can target certain audiences and certain industries that, even though you're not showing your face in this channel, you still want to make it accessible for companies wanting to reach out to this channel to work with the channel. And trust me, it still can happen, even though there's no personality behind it, right? sounds funny to say, but if you're very, very niche specific on your cash cow, where's the cash come from then, bro? They're others. Then obviously these niche specific businesses will want to work with you regardless of if you're showing your face or not. Think about digital products that you can make within that industry and niche. Think about merchandise, and the list goes on and on and on. We all know this day and age, there are a million ways to make money on the internet.
Whoa.
When I started my Cash Cow channel, the whole aim for it for me was I wanted this to be an asset, okay? I didn't want it to be a liability. I didn't want it to be something that was continuously taking money out of my pocket and not putting money back in. But for it to be an asset, I had to build it to a point that it didn't require me whatsoever, because quite clearly this channel, it requires me. It requires me sitting down, getting in front of a camera, being in the right mood to hit record, thumbnails, look at what, la la la
la la. Tell me what you know about this crypto thing then, yeah?
Whereas a Cash Cow channel, I know now that I can completely outsource everything from start to finish. So if I want to do nothing all day, then the channel is gonna still have the content going out, right? And YouTube is always changing, so please be aware that this isn't gonna happen overnight. Please try and be consistent with it. But the great thing about a Cash Cow channel is it's not like a personal brand channel where there's only so many hours in a day that I can sit in front of this camera, press record, and have the energy to do so. Whereas a Cash Cow channel, I could literally upload 5-10 videos a day if I had, you know, the investment to do so, to pay these people to make the videos. And obviously, like anything, it's a bit of a risk because, you know, how long is it going to be until you get monetized? How long is it going to be until you make that money back from Google AdSense? Are you even going to get monetized? You know, this is a risk that you obviously have to taste. I'm going to get a taste. But no risk, no reward, in my opinion. And the best thing about a cash cow channel is as soon as it's profitable, you can continue to reinvest that money back into the channel and make more and more videos and then make more and more income from that channel. Or you could get one of the cash cow channels to be profitable and then invest the difference into a new cash cow channel, which is definitely something that I am looking into now my cash cow channel has sort of gone to that point. Also, a very, very important point is you haven't got to have lighting, you haven't got to have a camera. I mean, it would be beneficial for you to have a camera, but I would definitely suggest starting off with, I mean, the thing is with a cash cow channel, man, like it requires literally no upfront cost. It's free to upload videos onto YouTube. You can do all of the work yourself. The only thing I would say about doing the work all yourself from the get-go is you don't want people to expect you being the voiceover. That's the only thing I would say. And it's something that I did in the past. And then when I then hired a narrator, you had all the comments like, I don't like this narrator. I don't want to. And obviously, it doesn't necessarily matter because that is what the channel is. I think the first 10 videos were me doing the voiceover. And then when I hired a narrator, like, obviously, all of the comments were a bit like, who's this guy? So I would personally suggest, even if you don't plan on putting like a lot of money towards this, just dabble with you doing everything else except from the voiceover. So try and hire someone to do the voiceover and then you do everything else. Do the video title, you create the thumbnail, you write the script, get someone to do the narration, get someone to do the voiceover, and then you edit it all together. So guys, let me know in the comments below what type of cash cow channel you are looking to make. If you enjoyed the video, leave it a like. If you're new around here, don't forget to press subscribe and I'll see you in the next video. Peace. Are we still rolling, yeah? And don't forget to never stop designing the future. Boom!